Hello, everybody. This is Carl Ravitch, and we are set to take you out to today's exhibition matchup. Up next, Interleague Baseball, the Houston Astros and the Chicago White Sox. Taking the ball for each club tonight, a couple of guys just raring to go.
Roger Clemens
will take the ball for the Astros in this one.
Mark Burley
will be on the mound for the White Sox. That'll do it from here. It's now time for baseball in Chicago. John Miller and Hall of Famer Joe Morgan describe all the action. Guys.
Welcome to U.S. Cellular Field on the south side of Chicago, home of the White Sox. And we are ready to go with what should be an entertaining matchup. We're getting ready for some exhibition baseball now coming up.
Tonight, it's the Houston Astros taking on the Chicago White Sox.
This is John Miller along with Joe Morgan, and we're ready to bring you all the excitement of this ballgame. Now, Joe, before we go to the first pitch of the ballgame, what about the Astros in this game?
Well, they're lucky to have a Craig Biggio in their lineup. He's been one of the most consistent hitters in the last decade and a half. It's not every day that you see someone who's that consistent and productive over that many years. He'll be a factor in this one.
Mark Burley
will be doing the pitching. He won 16 games last year. Opposing ball clubs hitting 271 when he's been on the mound this year. Now the pitcher is towing the pitching slab. It looks like we're just about ready to get started.
First pitch to him.
That's at the knees for a called strike.
He had movement on that changeup, and it moved down and in.
The pitch.
The 0-1 pitch, a fastball swung on and missed, 0-2. Good cutter, swung on and missed for the first out.
Good pitch on the outside edge. He couldn't do anything with that one. That's a tough pitch with two strikes.
Here's the lineup for Houston.
Morgan Ensberg
is hitting that big fourth spot in the order. Base is empty with one out.
First pitch on the way.
Hurt! One.
Got the curve by him that time, and he's in control, 0-2.
Go home, Biggio!
Changeup, swung on a miss, and that was out number two.
He was looking for a fastball, John, but he got the changeup. Swung right through it, strike three. Just a real risky pitch here, but he comes out alive. This one's right down the pipe, and the batter simply whiffed it. Just amazing.
He's lucky that ball didn't get tattooed.
Not a recommended location, but it worked.
Let's take a look at the White Sox as they take the field and their defense. Base is empty, two down here.
First pitch, here it comes.
Ball a great one. Pitcher changes the eye level of the hitter. Upstairs, then downstairs.
Now the 1-0 pitch.
Hike one.
Fastball waved at and missed, 1-1.
And man, that's 1-on-1 power baseball right there.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
Ball
just
two.
Off the inside edge. 2-1.
Forget about it, Bergman.
The 2-1 pitch. Hit in the air toward foul territory down the left field line. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a line drive. Uribe is racing, and he gets there for the out.
And this one definitely deserves another look.
Great heads-up play for the out.
Nothing doing here this half inning. Now we go to the last of the first, and we have no score. Roger Clemens
will be going for them in the role of starting pitcher today. He had 18 wins for the club last year.
Well, you know you're in good shape if you've got Roger Clemens on the mound. The Rocket had an unbelievable season last year. Here's a guy who had an amazing career, retires at the top of his game, then comes back and posts his best numbers in years. He's one of the greatest of all time.
Fastball swung on and missed, 0-1. Here's one popped foul to short right. Here it comes. There's a swing and a rocket toward short. Everett is there.
John, now they're really in business. A base hit with no one out.
Now the lineup for the White Sox.
Number 15
is in that number 2 spot in the batting order. Runner at first.
First pitch on the way. Started to go around, but it's in there for a called strike anyway. 0-1. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. Palmeiro boots it.
This is one he'd probably rather we didn't show on replay, John.
Yeah, but that's just not the way we are. Whether they're good plays or bad, we show them all. And I'm sure he'd rather not remember this one. This was not a good one.
You got that right.
Here's the Astros defense. Nobody out. Runners on first and third.
Now a throw over, and he dives back safely.
Nobody out. Runners on first and third.
First pitch to him, and he tries to get one down. One run is in.
This is a safety squeeze. The runner at third wasn't breaking, but once he sees the ball hit the ground, he runs home and he scores the run. And I guess it's time for a little heart-to-heart talk here, John. It doesn't seem like they're going to pull him right away, probably just considering making the change later on.
Paul Konerko will be batting here. Last year he had 41 home runs with a .481 career slugging percentage.
He bunts the ball. The second for one. On to first. Safe as they can't get the back end. Aaron Rowan
up to the plate. Last season he clobbered 24 home runs. He's slugging .475 for his career.
First pitch on the way. Fastball swung on and missed. 0-1.
Pitch on the way.
On the ground to third. One run is in. The throw to third.
John, never underestimate the importance of an early lead. It can allow your pitchers to pitch with confidence. And it doesn't hurt to make that starter throw a lot of pitches early either.
Jermaine Dye
comes in here. Last season, he knocked 23 out of the park. A career slugging percentage of .463. Runners at first and second with one out.
First pitch to him. This one swung on and fouled away. Swing and a miss, and he falls behind 0-2. Swing and a miss on the splitter, and that's out number two.
Great location on this pitch. He kept it down and caught the corner. Three pitches and he's out. Great pitching here. Let's take a look at the replay.
Yeah, strike one, strike two, strike three, and see you later.
A.J. Pierzynski
steps up. He hit the 11 homers all last year. With his career slugging percentage under .440.
This is swung on and hit in the air.
Tavares
has got it and the side is retired. The Chicago White Sox get four hits in the inning and push two runs across the plate. We'll go to the top of the second.
The Chicago White Sox are leading
2-0.
The heart of the order coming up next.
Jason Lane
is due up second in the next half inning.
First pitch, here it comes. Got him to chase that outside pitch for strike one.
He deals.
There's a swing and a ground ball. Burley has it. And he throws on to first for the out. One away.
Lane comes up for the first time right now. One out, nobody on.
First pitch to him. First pitch is a changeup. Looked at 0-1. Good cut fastball that time. He's in control, 0-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out on the breaking ball. Two down.
Man, that's a tough pitch. All he could hope to do there is foul it off, but he swung right through it. We're going to take a look at this curve. This one's coming in on him, and he chases it. Tough, tough pitch to handle.
Not too much you could have done there, Joe. The pitcher just made him look bad right there.
Yeah, he did. That was just a great pitch for that situation.
First pitch, here it comes. And this one's grounded to second. Number 15 is there to play it on the hop. Throws on to first, and the side is retired. Nothing doing here this happening. Now we'll move on to the bottom of the second.
The White Sox have the lead.
2-0.
It's the number 8, 9, and 1 hitters coming up.
Juan Uribe
is due up second in the next half inning.
First pitch on the way.
Quick one.
Got the fastball by him that time, and he's in control now, 0-2.
He kicks, he throws.
There's a swing and a rocket toward short. Throw on to first, in time, one away. Uribe
steps to the plate for the first time in this one. One out, nobody on.
First pitch to him. Swings and misses at that fastball. It's 0-1. Now here's the ball grounded towards the hole. Everett has got it. And he throws the first in time for out number two.
The shortstop makes a nice play here, and they get the force out at first.
Well, we'll get a chance to make our own opinion on this one, Joe, as we get a look at it in slow motion with the replay. He almost did make it.
Well, let's just see how close this play was. He's really busting down the line, and they just do manage to get him at first.
First pitch, here it comes. Swings and misses at that fastball. It's 0-1.
Ground to second.
And he boots it.
Burke
has it. And he'll have no play on this one. That'll go as an error.
Here's what happened on the error. It looked like he was going to come up with it, but he gets away.
Now, this is just not supposed to happen in big league ball, Joe. I mean, you say to yourself, wait a minute. I don't get it. Is it the big leagues or what? Two outs, a man on first.
Sliders in there. No ball to the strike.
The pitch.
The 0-1 pitch is a changeup, swung on and missed, 0-2. Now a throw over. Oh, and he has to dive back, but he's just barely in there. The slider swung on and missed. He struck him out, and the side is retired.
Here's a replay of those last three pitches. Great pitches on the replay.
Yeah, nice work, Joe. He didn't give him much to hit that time, that's for sure.
The Chicago White Sox can't get anybody home here this happening. We'll go to the top of inning number three. The White Sox on top, 2-0.
It's the last third of the batting order coming up.
Adam Everett
will be the first man up.
First pitch on the way. Swung on and grounded towards the hole. The throw to second.
That will go as their first hit in the ballgame, and it comes here in the third. Now let's see if they can capitalize on it.
Runner at first, nobody out.
First, he bunts the ball.
Gets one at second, over to first, and two. Very close play, and they don't get the double play, not this time. Chris Burke comes to bat here. He didn't have any home runs last season. He didn't have any RBIs last season. One out, man on first.
There he goes for second. And he's in there at second.
They just give away an out here. They've got this guy picked off, but they still allow him to get in there safely. That hurts. The throw is too late here, John, and he's able to steal second base with a good slide.
Yeah, I thought the slide maybe was the key to the whole thing, Joe.
I noticed on the replay, John, he didn't have too much of a lead at first either.
He throws.
On the ground to short. Throws to first, and he's retired for out number two.
Willie Tavares steps up to the plate. He didn't have any home runs last season, with a career slugging percentage under 400.
Well, every once in a while, you got to let it go. That's a big power swing right there.
This is swung on and hit on the ground. Burley is there. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. The Houston Astros pick up a hit but leave a man at second and fail to score. Now we'll go to the bottom of the third. The White Sox lead it 2-0.
The 3-4-5 hitters, the big hitters coming up.
Paul Konerko
is due up second in the next half inning.
First pitch on the way. That's in there for a strike. Good hard splitter swung on and missed. It's 0-2. Swung on and lined softly to the right side.
He might have himself a hit if he can loft this a little more, but as it is, it's nothing more than an easy play for the second baseman.
Konerko will be the batter. 0-1 thus far.
Base is empty. One out.
First pitch to him. Slider swung on and missed. 0-1.
And he delivers.
Swing and a miss. And he's behind in the count now. 0-2.
Toughest spot for a hitter. 0-2. The pitcher has a lot of pitches he can play with.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the second out of the inning.
Well, he was looking dead red. He got the fastball, but he could not make contact. Strike three. Well, John, let's see this pitch again. Here's another look at the four-seam fastball.
He just looks silly flailing away at this one, Joe, as if he were trying to swat bugs or something.
Well, that's what pitches up and in can do to a hitter. If you miss it, you'll look.
Swung on and grounded towards the hole. The throw to second.
Johnny found a pitch to his liking that time. Let's see if they can get something started here with two outs.
Dye will be the batter. 0-1 thus far. First pitch on the way. Starts him off with one at the knees for a strike. Now a swing and a ball hit on the ground. Burnt is there to play it on the hop. Throws to first in time for out number three. No runs on a hit and one man left out. We're through three here at the ballpark. The White Sox lead 2-0.
And they've got the 2-3-4 spots due up next.
Lance Berkman
is a dangerous hitter. He'll be up second in the inning.
Curveball just misses. One ball, no strikes. Here's the 1-0 delivery. One ball, one strike. Here's the pitch. Grounded down the first baseline. Konerko has it on the hop. And a step on first for out number one. Berkman.
He's a switch hitter, and he's going to bat from the right side here. Nobody on base with one out.
First pitch on the way. Fastball swung on and missed. 0-1.
He throws.
And he swings and hits this one foul.
Hey, Berkman, you're a whiffer.
Swung on, hit softly towards the hole. Creedy has got it. Throws the first, and he's retired for out number two. Konerko
is very impressive here. A great play. He was off balance and still made the play.
Nothing quite like it. He knows it's urgent, and he can't hold on any longer. He fills this thing out and just uses his instinct. Nice job.
Two outs, nobody on.
Ball one.
Now the 1-0 pitch. And he fouls this one off.
Foul.
Let's see it. More get it.
One ball, one strike, the pitch. This one swung on and hit in the air. Posednik is there, and he puts it away for out number three. And they go down in short order. On now to the last of the fourth. The White Sox are out in front, 2-0.
It's the bottom three of the batting order coming up.
A.J. Pierzynski
will be the first man up.
First pitch to him. Fastball in there, and it's 0-1.
Strike two.
Let's go, AJ.
He's
big out. Swing and a miss on a fastball. And he struck him out. One away.
Great location on this pitch. He kept it down and caught the corner. Let's take a look at the pitching sequence, John. He delivers three straight strikes.
Yeah, that's not much of a sequence. Just get to the plate and then take your spot on the bench.
First pitch, here it comes. Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. Tavares is there, and he gloves it for the out.
The center fielder has to range to his left, but he's able to track it down over there and put it away.
Base is empty, two down.
First pitch, here it comes.
Foul.
Now a swing and a ball hit foul.
He throws.
Swings and lines this one back up the middle. Everett is there. And it's in time. From his knees, he gets him. Wow. So they go down in short order.
We've completed four full here in Chicago. The Chicago White Sox are leading
2-0.
The 5-6-7 spots due up.
Jason Lane
will be the first man up.
First pitch on the way. Lined hard down the left field line. And fouled. Now here's the ball grounded towards the hole. The throw to second.
Leadoff man's aboard. Let's see how they decide to play it here.
Palmeiro will be the batter. 0 for 1 thus far. First pitch to him.
Ball one.
Changeup just misses. 1-0. He's at the belt. The one. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. Posednik glides over and makes the catch for the out.
This one's headed towards the gap, but it's a bit high, and the left fielder moves to his left, and he puts it away.
With one out, there's a runner at first.
First pitch to him. Hit in the air to left center. Posednik is over, and he makes the catch for the out.
He gets good wood on this one, but it hangs up long enough for the left fielder to get there without much trouble.
Runner at first with two down.
First pitch on the way. Starts him out with a fastball for a strike.
The pitch.
Strike two at the knees. Nothing in two.
Got nothing, Dartmouth boy.
Now here's the ball grounded towards the hole. The throw on the second for the force, and the side is retired. So, no runs, one hit, and nobody left. On we go to the last half of inning number five.
The White Sox have the lead,
2-0.
Top of the lineup coming up next.
Carl Everett
will try and get something started. He's up third in the next inning.
First pitch, here it comes. Swing and a miss. He's just a little bit under it, 0-1. Hit in the air to left center. And it drops in for a base hit. The throw to second.
The leadoff man is on, and they'll try to extend this lead a little bit.
Number 15 will step in. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. And he has to dive back. Something may be up here.
Runner at first, nobody out.
There he goes, towards second. And he tries to get one down. And his throw is in time for out number one. Everett
will stand in. He's a switch hitter, batting left-handed. One man out, one man on, a runner at second.
Now a spin and a throw back to second. And he has to dive, but he's back in time.
One out, runner at second.
First pitch, here it comes.
Ball one.
And they pitch out, but nothing doing that time. Ready with the 1-0 pitch.
Ball
pitch
two.
Out, but nothing
That's
doing
up.
That time. A throw back to second, but he's back in time. And he's running, heading for third. And he's in there at third.
I like this steal, John. He had a good lead off second, and he dives into third base and beats the throw.
Well, you're one of the great base dealers of all time, Joe, so if you like it, I definitely like it.
I like it.
Now he's set. Here's the 3-0 pitch.
Ball four. Take
John, base. This pitch had to be in the middle of the plate, not up and away.
Paul Konerko
comes up now. Last year he had 41 home runs with a .481 career slugging percentage.
First pitch on the way. Swing and a miss, although he looked to be right on it.
Here it comes.
Here's a swing and a fly ball. And that's a fair ball heading towards the corner. The throw to the plate. The throw.
John, nice job of getting the double. He took the fastball and ripped it. Good efficient swing right there.
Aaron Rowan
comes in ready to hit. Last season he covered 24 home runs. He's slugging .475.
There's a bullet towards third. And he'll be tagged out on a bonehead base running play.
Joe, you got to give the guy props on this one. He just did it all himself.
John, sometimes you end up in this position where that's the only option you have. On this play, he came through big time.
The White Sox score once on two hits with one man left out. We've played five full. The White Sox lead it 3-0.
Many of you may have just tuned in, and for your benefit, I'll remind you that I'm John Miller. That's Joe Morgan over there. The numbers 9, 1, and 2 spots due up next.
Craig Biggio
will try and get some.
Swung on and ripped towards second. Number 15 has it. And he throws on to first for the out. 1-1.
Tavares
will stand in. He's 0-for-2 thus far.
Nobody on base with one out.
First pitch on the way. Called a strike. 0-1.
Well, they missed down and in. I don't think they were trying to throw it there, but that's where it ended up.
Here's the 1-1 pitch.
Hurt to.
The 1-2 pitch.
And he swings and hits this one foul.
The 1-2 pitch.
Fastball. Got him. Two down.
He's obviously a low ball hitter. Couldn't catch up with that one. That's up and away. Let's see this one again. It was a four-seam fastball. He decides to swing at this one, but he couldn't get the bat square to the ball in time.
Excellent pitching right there.
It certainly was. Got to give credit to the pitcher for getting him to chase that one.
Base is empty. Two down here.
First pitch, here it comes.
Yes, he went.
Checked his swing, but it's in there. 0-1.
He delivers.
The 0-1 pitch, a fastball swung on and missed. 0-2.
Hey, Biggio, let the kids play, will ya?
Fastball swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired.
Nice pitch on the inside corner, and he got him chasing it.
Boy, he wanted that one. You could see it in his body language. He just got out-dueled by the pitcher on that one.
The Astros aren't able to push across anything and have been shut out through the first six. On to the bottom of the sixth. The White Sox on top, 3-0.
The numbers 6, 7, 8 hitters are coming up.
Jermaine Dye
will be the first man up.
First pitch to him. Cut on and missed, and it's 0-1. Got the fastball by him that time, and he's in control now, 0-2. Split finger pitch, got it. And that's out number one.
A lot of people say the splitter is the toughest pitch to hit now, John. That one was really tough.
Pierzynski will stand in. He's 0-2 thus far.
Base is empty with one out.
First pitch, here it comes. There's a swing and a ground ball. Astacio has got it. On to first, 2 down. Creedy will stand in. He's 0-2 thus far.
2 outs, nobody on.
First pitch on the way.
Ball one.
Here's the 1-0 delivery. This ball is hammered down the left field line, but it goes foul. The 1-1 pitch on the way. Swing and a miss on a fastball, and it's 1-2.
The 1-2 pitch coming.
Grounded softly to short. Ensberg has it. He'll throw on to first, and the side is retired. 3 up, 3 down this happening. At the end of 6 full innings, the White Sox are out in front, 3-0.
The numbers 3, 4, 5 spots in the order is coming up next.
Lance Berkman
will be the first man up.
First pitch to him. Swings and misses at the good change. It's 0-1.
The pitch.
Well, every once in a while, you got to let it go. That's a big power swing right there.
Forget about it, Berkman.
Fastball swung and missed. He struck him out. One away.
John, that's right at the knees. Great location with 2 strikes. Fooled him completely.
John, let's check out this 4-seam fastball. It's down in the zone, but it's definitely a hittable pitch. Looked like the pitcher just caught him looking for something else, and it threw off his timing.
It was an outstanding pitch, Joe, and that will give the rest of the lineup something else to think about whenever they've gotten 2 strikes against this pitcher.
Change up in there for a called strike. The 0-1 pitch is a curve, swung on and missed, 0-2.
Let's see it, Morgan!
A swing and a fly ball to left center field. Posednik goes over and puts it away.
And you want to talk about settling in, 8 in a row he's retired now.
Jason Lane
comes in. His average right now at 273. He has a career batting average of 280.
There's a swing and a rocket towards short. Uribe is up with it. Throws to first, and the side is retired. The Astros are frustrated yet again, and that's now 7 shutout innings.
Now
7 in a stretch here in the South Side of Chicago. The White Sox lead 3-0.
They'll start at the ninth spot and then go to the top of the order next.
Juan Uribe
will be the first man up.
First pitch, here it comes. Cut on and missed, and it's 0-1.
On the way. There's a swing and a drive. Down the line and left. It is carrying back there. And foul.
Curveball got him. One away.
Man, that's right down the middle, and he missed it. Strike three. Let's see this curve. You'll see this thing get tracked to the lower corner of the plate. It looked like the batter thought he had this one, but in the end, it was just too much for him to handle.
Not the way he was looking to end that at bat, Joe.
Posednik will bat here. He's 2-for-3 thus far. First pitch on the way. Breaking ball swung on and missed. It's 0-1. That's low. One ball, one strike. One ball, one strike, the pitch. The 1-1 pitch is a fastball swung on and missed. 1-2.
Let's go, Scotty P.
Here's the 1-2 pitch on the way. Swung on and grounded towards the hole. Berkman has it. His throw not in time, and that'll be an infield single.
Well, John, let's see this pitch again. It was a curve.
Jeff Blum
steps up now, hitting 216. Hitting 254 in his career. One out, a runner on second.
A dive, but he's back in easily.
Man on second, one out.
First pitch to him. Swings and misses at the curve. 0-1.
Pitch on the way.
Good hard splitter that time, and he's in control. It's 0-2.
The pitcher has him 0-2. I look for him to go inside and then back.
There's a swing and a line drive. And he's in trouble as he's tagged out between first and second.
And it turned into an easy double play. The base runner with a bonehead play.
Well, you got to get back, John, in that situation. Not great decision making there.
That inning didn't last long. We'll move ahead to the eighth.
The Chicago White Sox are leading
3-0.
The 6-7-8 hitters are coming up next.
Adam Everett
is due up second in the next half inning.
First pitch to him.
Ball that one. Pitch will keep him from leaning out over the plate on the next one.
The 1-0 pitch on the way. Swings and lines this one towards the hole. Lowe is there, and he puts it away for out number one. Everett will step in. 1-for-2 in the ballgame.
One out. Nobody on.
Yep.
Started to go around, but it's in there for a called strike anyway. 0-1. The 0-1 pitch is a curve in for a called strike. Swung on and grounded towards the hole. Creedy is there. And he throws the first in time for out number two. Ausmus will stand in. He's 0-for-2 thus far.
Two outs, nobody on.
First pitch, here it comes. Starts him off with one in there for a strike.
He deals.
The 0-1 pitch is a fastball for a called strike. Swung on and lined out to right center. As it will, in fact, as you see, go all the way to the wall. The throw to third.
John, you see his swing's very flat here. He keeps the bat in the zone and drives this ball. Let's see if this will start a two-out rally.
Burke will stand in. He's 0-for-2 thus far.
Two outs and a runner on second.
First pitch on the way. And they pitch out, but nothing was going on there. Here's a spin and a throw behind the runner. Trying to keep him close, and he's back in time. He's at the belt. The 1-0 pitch. Two. And here's one high and away for a ball. 2-0. He's ready. The 2-0 pitch.
Ball three.
And that's high and away for ball three. He's on top. The 3-0 pitch.
Ball four.
John, this pitch had to be in the middle of the plate, not up and away.
Willie Tavares comes in. He didn't have any home runs last season. With a career slugging percentage under 400.
First pitch, here it comes. Fastball in there for a called strike. They throw behind the runner at second, and he's back easily, but he made a dive just to make sure. There he goes for second. And he's in there at third.
Here's the replay, John. We'll see a double steal here, and that's a victory in its own right.
Yeah, but you know, you don't often see it with two down.
Well, because you got to make it, John. The guy's already in scoring position.
He kicks. He throws.
Fastball swung out and missed, and the side is retired. The Houston Astros are held in check again, as they are now scoreless through eight. Here come the White Sox in the home half of the eighth.
The White Sox have the lead
3-0.
The 3-4-5 spots in the order coming up next.
Carl Everett
will be the first man up.
Swings and misses at the curve. 0-1. Hit sharply towards the hole. The throw to second.
They're starting this inning out in grand style. The base hit with no one out.
Logue
will get his first plate appearance of the game right now.
Now a throw over.
One man on, nobody out.
A throw back to the bag. And he has to dive, but he's back in time.
Runner at first.
First pitch to him.
Oh. Popped him up.
Back behind home plate. And a throw over to first, and he dives back safely. Swing and a miss, and he falls behind 0-2. Now a throw over, but he's back in time. Fastball swung on and missed. He struck him out. One away.
Well, he was looking dead red. He got the fastball, but he could not make contact. Strike three.
Rowan will bat here. He drove in a run earlier in this game.
One out, man on first.
There he goes for second.
Ball one.
And he's in there at second.
Good idea that time to step off once he sees the runners in motion. But they're a little slow on the trigger, so he's able to get there anyway. Here's another look at the steal. He beats the throw easily.
Yeah, and I tell you what, he didn't have much of a jump from first base, Joe. That slide, I thought, was a big one.
Well, sometimes, John, you can tip the pitcher off if you get too...
There's a swing and a rocket towards short. And he throws the first in time for out number two.
Might have had a shot to get the guy going to third that time, but they take the sure out at first for the second out of the inning. Man, the ballpark is rocking. The fans are really happy with this 3-1 lead.
Fastball swung on, missed 0-1.
He delivers.
Good hard splitter swung on, missed with 0-2.
He's way ahead in the count. All the pressure falls on the hitter now. He's got to make contact.
He's out of there.
Fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired.
Three pitches, and he's out. Great pitching here. Let's take a look at the replay.
Yeah, strike one, strike two, strike three, and see you later.
The Chicago White Sox get a man to third, but can't bring him in. With through eight, ninth inning coming up.
The White Sox have the lead 3-0. And they've got the 2-3-4 spots due up next.
Lance Berkman,
a powerful, tough hitter. He's coming up second in the inning.
Took something off and it swung on and missed. Strike one. Here's a swing and a ball popped up. Foul down the left field line. This is swung on and lined softly towards right center. Blum takes charge in this one and he puts it away for the out. Berkman,
a switch hitter batting left-handed. Base is empty. One out.
First pitch on the way. Swing and a miss for strike one.
Ooh, that's a big fly swing right there.
Swing and a ball hit in the air into foul territory in shallow right. There's a swing and a ground ball. Hermanson is right there. And a good throw gets him. Two down.
Ensberg will step in. He's 0 for 3 up to this point. Base is empty. Two down.
First pitch to him.
Hit one.
The pitch.
After two pitches away, that one inside keeps you honest.
Here's the 1-1 pitch.
Well, he didn't get cheated. That's the big class winner.
The 1-2 pitch.
Fastball swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. The Chicago White Sox
come out victorious here, Joe. And these fans are going to head home happy. The home team gave them the happy ending.
Well, they should be happy, John. Not only did they win the ball game, but they played well. And in the end, they wore their opponents down, so the home team goes away happy.
Mark Burley
pitched shutout ball in this one, and there is absolutely no question that he's our player of the game.
Well, this is what managers mean when they talk about quality starts. Anytime your starter can go deep into the game and put you in a position to win, that's what you're looking for. And that's what he got here today. And as for an added bonus, the bullpen closed it out strong.
That wraps things up from here. Until next time, this is John Miller for Joe Morgan and our entire crew saying so long, thanks for tuning in, and good night. Once